The one thing that successful people have in common is they fail again and again and again, and they get back up again and again and again. Whether you're a successful TV presenter or actor or athlete or sports or guru or whatnot, but everybody has this in common. Fail, 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 and then grow, grow, grow. Success and failure go hand in hand. That's a true fact. And I'm gonna explain all of this in this video. So make sure you stay until the end because there's some action steps for you and some freebies as well. And if you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe to my channel to create the life that you desire. That's what I do. I help you take the steps to create that desired, meaningful, fulfilled life that you deserve and not expected to live. So I'm gonna go inside right now because there's too many birds chirping away and I'm gonna dig into this topic. It's a journey, not a destination. Focus on the journey, not on the destination. No matter how perfect your plan is, there will always be unexpected detours. In fact, from now on, if you haven't done so already, I want you to expect detours. I want you to expect detours. Because growth and progress is found along the way, not at the end destination. Progress is found along your path, not at the end destination. There is a famous quote from an unknown author saying, "The road to success is paved with failure." The road to success is paved with failure. And I love this because failure and making mistakes is part of the game. You have to enjoy the game, like Gary Vee says all the time. Enjoy the game, enjoy the process. Don't stick to the end destination. No, it's the journey you have to focus on. And I want to talk about two things. The journey to focus on includes all of your achievements and your wins, but the journey involves failing and making mistakes. So failing and making mistakes, let's talk about that. I have a quote I use a lot in my speeches, which is, I never make the same mistake twice. I make it 5 or 6 times just to make sure. Why? Because making mistakes helps you grow. Making mistakes is to learn from. Failure, in my book, I said, failure is the greatest feedback. It's the greatest teacher. Because it's through failing that you learn. Think about Michael Jordan. How many, I think 300 games he lost, and I don't know how many thousands, I think 9,000 shots he lost. But yet he says, that's exactly why I succeed. Through those failures, I succeeded and I found my success. Think about the old time example of Edison, you know, with the light bulb. I mean, how many times and attempts and thousands of attempts he tried before that light bulb gave light. But did he say, oh, I failed, so now I'm not going to try again? No, you try again and you try again and you try again. And you learn and you learn and you learn and you do it differently all the time. You do it differently because you learn and then you try again and you do it a bit differently and try again and do it a bit differently. So you learn from your mistakes and it's the greatest feedback. So I encourage you to fail. I encourage you to make mistakes. I know it sucks, but what do you expect? If you don't fail, it means you don't even try and you're wasting growth and change and progress because you're staying stuck and you're limiting yourself. So I want you to take charge, take responsibility, be proactive and put in the effort. Because it's through that progress and that growth, and it's along that path towards success, you don't see the destination, but it's all of the failures and the mistakes and the trials and errors that you grow and you change and you transform yourself. Now think about a little small baby trying to make his first steps. So he gets up, he tries, he falls back, gets up, tries, falls again. Are you angry at that baby saying, oh my gosh, you stupid baby, you can't even walk? No. So why are you being so hard on yourself? Baby steps, right? I mean, just try and fail and fall and get back up. And it's those who keep getting back up who will succeed, because the growth is in the progress. The success is in the progress. It's along the path. It's not your end destination. But the thing that's so scary is the fear, because it's the fear of the unknown, because you don't see that destination, right? So I always like to compare it with standing on a very foggy beach, right? And you're standing there and you want to see across that fog, but you can't. You can't. So you take a step and another step and another step and another step, and you kind of move through that fog. That's exactly how your journey is. You cannot see the end destination. So there is the fear of the unknown, which I'll talk about, you know, I talk about that a lot in when I talk about fear, but it's the fear of the unknown that scares you. But you know what? You don't know what you don't know. So why are you afraid of what you don't know? You have to take every single step to move past that fog, and then you will know. I'll talk more about that when I talk about fear, but yeah, that's it, you know? So you don't know what you don't know. And I want you to, secondly, focus on your achievements and focus on all the things that you have done and be in a mindset of abundance and not lack. So that's the second thing I want to talk about in this particular step here of, or key element of being in a journey and not a destination, because we always focus on, oh, I want this, and I don't have a success yet, and I don't have the business yet, and I don't have my book yet, and I don't have my course, and I need, and I lack, and that will put you in a place of lack. If you focus on lack, that's what you will get. You will get more of things that you lack. It's as simple as that. It's a law of attraction. You attract what you like or not. I mean, it's as simple as that. But if you focus on abundance, the things that you have, be grateful of the things that you have. I have a roof over my head. I have food I can pay for. I have so many things. I have my family to be grateful for. So I focus on all of the abundance and I attract more abundance and more success. If I keep focusing on, I'm not so good yet, and I'm not far enough on my YouTube channel, and I don't have enough subscribers yet, and I want more money, and I don't have enough to travel, and I want and I need and I lack, then that's just, I'm just gonna stay stuck and frustrated and being in a place of resistance. So no more of that. Be in a place of abundance, because I am growing. I'm growing on YouTube. I have created books. I have amazing speakers opportunities. I have amazing clients. So I'm in a place of abundance and I'm grateful for that. So I want you to remember that. It's a journey and not a destination. And the fun is in the journey. The fun is along the way. That's where you grow. That's where you succeed. And failing and making mistakes, please do, because it's part of it. Expect those detours and focus on abundance. That's the conclusion of the journey versus the destination. It is time for action. Number one, I want you to comment below. What have you learned? What's your biggest takeaway? What is the quote that you prefer? Just tell us and comment it below, because journaling, noting, writing things down, it's gonna help you in your growth. Number two, if you're still feeling stuck and you're like, yeah, but I don't know what to do and I wanna change, but I'm not sure and I'm just stuck, then grab that free gift. It's a free training with 7 steps to help you get unstuck. The link is right below this video. And number three, make sure you watch the next video that will show up right away, because you wanna create that life you desire. And there's loads and loads of videos and content that I make for you to make those changes. Small changes all the time, but then you can live a desired life just like I created for myself, standing in Australia at the moment, beautiful weather in the winter, and I created this. So can you. See you in the next video.